皆様こんばんは。日本語講師レイナです。お久しぶりかな。今回もリクエストをいただいたので、そのリクエストに対するレッスンを行いたいと思います。
Yeah, I'm here to fulfill another request, and which is great. So if you have any question or topic suggestion, please let me know down below, okay? Before I forget, I should just say so now. Anyways, today's topic is, okay, what is the female-like Japanese and then what is the male-like Japanese?I hear sometimes that when you learn Japanese from your girlfriend or wife, and your Japanese tend to become a little bit like female-like, right? And this person is specifically asking me what to watch out for, or is there any patterns? Okay, before going into details, Japanese, unlike French or Spanish, we don't have this male nouns or female nouns, just so you know. Some words are more likely used by female or male, yeah, but not an actualfemale, male meaning in the word itself. Okay? Alright, so let's go into a little bit of pattern here, okay? Ready? One, prefix, o. You can add o in front of nouns, and then some of them becoming like a female-like. Okay? So if you are female, better bet is add o in front of nouns. But don't take me wrong, though. Not every single noun, okay? But a lot of them. And if you want to be safe, and if you're a man, drop o, okay? For example, we don't use o for sunglasses, all right? Most of the katakana words, we don't use o in front of it, if I think about it. Like TV, no o. Microphone, no o. Cup, no o. Okay, so that's a good thing to know. Good job, Reina. Let's go over some words.Water.
お水。
水。
A room. お部屋。
部屋。
Rice. お米。
米。
A store. お店。
店。Before moving on to the next topic, this O has a little bit of a special usage here, especially when you're in a hospitality industry or dealing with some clients. You put O in front of some nouns that even girls or female don't use it in a casual conversation. For example, car,
車,
I have the car ready for you at the hotels or whatever, okay?
お車をご用意いたしました。お車をご用意いたしました。
In this お車 situation, as I said, it's in a hospitality and a business situation, right? So it doesn't matter male or female, both use. Okay? Point two, postfix.There are certain female postfixes and then a male fixes, so I'm gonna just give you guys examples, okay? Example A.
でしょ?
だろ?
食べるでしょ?
食べるだろ? Eating, right?
寝るでしょ?
寝るだろ? Going to bed, right?
行くでしょ?
行くだろ?Coming with me, right? Or going, right?
B. よ。
ぜ。
遊ぼうよ。
遊ぼうぜ。Let's go play, or let's hang.
カラオケ行こうよ。
カラオケ行こうぜ。Let's go to karaoke.
旅行しよ。
旅行しようぜ。Let's go somewhere. Let's go on a trip.C.
ね。
な?だろ? These are all the same meaning. Right?
するよね。
するよな。するだろ? You are doing that, right?
食べるよね。
食べるよな。食べるだろ? D.
の。
の can be used for both genders.
買うの?
買うの? Buying?
読むの?
読むの? Reading? D. This one male should stay away. Okay, this is just for female.
かしら彼女来るかしら
I'm wondering if she's coming.
彼女食べられるかしら
Wondering if she could eat it. D, do.
かな
It can be used by both genders.
つくかな
つくかな Wondering if it get there or wondering if it get turned on, like a light and stuff. Maybe you're wondering how can you tell the difference between those two tsuku if it's writing different Chinese characters, different kanjis. Okay, those are the postfixes. And I bet you there are more, but that's all I could think of. So if I missed it and if you are confused with something, let me know, okay?Last point, three, pronouns. A, I.
私
俺僕 You.
あなた
お前君てめえてめえ Please only use it when you're mad or when you're in a fight, okay? And 君 watch out. And if you can, stay away because...Some people feel like, you know, you are talking down on them if you use 君 She
彼女
彼女 He
彼
彼 Or あいつ That guy And also あいつ can be used for female as well if you are male, okay? They
彼らあの人たち
あの人たち is more like those guys, okay? 彼ら、あいつら、or やつら。We
私たち
俺ら、僕ら。And the female ones, I think it's okay for male to use it, but girls, stay away from the ones that guys are using.Okay, if you want to keep this girly image, I usually use these male ones to joke around with guys. So, okay. I hope this lesson was simple and get to the point. I didn't include too much of an example using sentences because it was about words and I didn't want to complicate things. But yeah, I hope now it's clear to you and you know which side you're using and which word or how to use things properly.
今回のレッスンはいかがでしたか？あまり例題は入っていませんが、女性的日本語、男性的日本語の違いについて明確になっていることを祈っています。それではまた次回お会いしましょう。日本語講師レイナでした。